Two male cubs were born in April 2011 into the Charleston pride of Mala Mala. Life wasn't easy for the Charleston boys, and odds were stacked against them from the beginning. In January 2012, the Charleston pride got into a serious clash with the neighboring Salaiti pride. This conflict turned out to be disastrous for the Charleston pride, and all members of the pride were killed, except for one lioness and two cubs. The last adult Charleston lioness took the task of raising these 9-month-old cubs. She had to take care of the cubs all by herself and without a pride. This task seemed impossible. Against all odds, the lone female astonishingly managed to raise the two cubs to independence, which is remarkable to say the least. In 2014, these two brothers had turned into huge male lions, and they looked far bigger for their age. With this massive size came the confidence which would lead them to greatness in the very near future. In May 2014, one of the Charleston males clashed with one of the Sand River males. This was beyond impressive, considering he was just 3 years old and was willing to trade blows with the strong, dominant male. ...2015 brought new challenges for the Charleston brothers, as they had to rescue their aunt and her two new cubs from Hilda's Rock female and her young son. By the end of 2015, both brothers started to explore new territories to establish themselves as the dominant males. During the following weeks, one of the brothers was seen with his canine hanging out. Apparently, the two brothers tried to hunt a giraffe, and one of them got kicked in the jaw, which resulted in a gruesome injury. This injury, however, didn't stop him from standing next to his brother, and they kept on pushing towards the southern section of Sabi Sand. They were seen deep into territory with the Four Ways males and the Salaiti pride. Upon entering their territory, they laid an open challenge, and conflict ensued with the Four Ways males. The outcome of the battle wasn't good for the defenders, and they lost their territory and pride to the Charleston brothers. Both Four Ways males appeared with injuries. They realized that they were no match for the new dominant males and moved further south into Kruger, where they would later establish a territory of their own. The Charleston males were now the dominant males of southern Sabi Sand. Not long after the takeover, they encountered their first challenge. They came into contact with the Kruger male and the Salala male solo. The Charleston males tracked down the enemy coalition and seriously injured the Kruger male. His body was later found on the eastern bank of the Sand River, while his partner was sent running into the Kruger Park by the Charleston brothers. This was a clear indicator that the two Charleston males were not to be messed with, and further cemented their grip over the southern parts of Sabi Sand. In early 2017, a coalition of 5 males was seen moving into Charleston territory. They entered the Charleston-controlled area from the east. Their arrival might have been the reason the Charleston brothers moved further south into Kruger Park. They were seen exploring this new area and following a new pride of females, which was a clear sign that they were going to stay in Kruger. After spending months in Kruger, the Charleston males returned to Sabi Sand in August 2017. They were seen in their old stomping grounds following a big buffalo herd. Both brothers took down a buffalo and went back to Kruger after a feast. They spent another year in Kruger Park before once again turning back to Sabi Sand. But this time, however, the cause of their return was the arrival of the new males in the area. In July 2018, 2 southern Avukas were laying claim onto the territory abandoned by the Charleston males. Upon hearing the roars of the new males, both brothers returned and gave a chase. But the two Avukas ran off to avoid the conflict with much stronger Charleston males. Immediately after this incident, the Charleston brothers went back to their territory in Kruger. In September 2018, a very distressing incident took place in Kruger. One of the Charleston males was seen with a snare around his body. He was able to break free, but the cable was still wrapped around his neck. This news made headlines on social media, and authorities of Kruger Park were informed, who successfully tracked the animal and removed the snare. After the snare incident, Charleston male successfully managed to join his brother and pride. His tooth that was hanging out also fell off during the following weeks. On the 25th of May, 2019, a male lion was found alongside a road near Skakuza. He was unable to move properly and was dragging his hindquarters. He turned out to be one of the Charleston males. After close inspection, the park officials decided to put down the animal and released a statement. The lone Charleston male has been seen on multiple occasions after the unfortunate demise of his brother. He still holds on to his territory and pride. Let's hope he successfully raises his offspring to independence, who will carry the Charleston legacy to the next generations.